From the moment the hospitals open for Bett 2017, 20 close on Saturday. More than one Palestinian child will have been killed. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
Shame on you, Hewlett
Packard!
In 2009, Hewlett Packard won the contract to supply all computer equipment to the Israeli military. In another contract, Hewlett Packard supplied configuration management database system for the Israeli Army's secret IT unit. Hewlett Packard is also implementing and assimilating an enterprise resource planning and management system for the Israeli Army. Hewlett Packard has been equipping the Israeli Army military for 11 years, since 2006. When it was first contracted to provide the IT infrastructure for the Israeli Navy in a pilot for implementing across the entire army, thus helping the Israeli Navy execute its illegal blockade of Gaza, which also began in 2006. Documents from Israel's Defense Ministry reveal that Israel uses a meticulously calculated, cold-blooded calorie count to limit food entering Gaza, to enforce a starvation diet on Gaza, where people are always starving but not quite dead from starvation. When hungry Gazans go fishing in their own waters, their boats are attacked by the Israeli Navy and their fishermen are abducted. The UN High Commissioner for Human Rights Navy, Pile, has stated that Israel's blockade of Gaza is illegal, that international humanitarian law prohibits starvation of civilians as a method of warfare, and it is also prohibited to impose collective punishment on civilians. We want to ask Hewlett Packard, are you proud of your role in the starvation of the people of Gaza, over half of which are children under 15 years old? Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Hewlett Packard also provides the IT services and infrastructure that enable the Israeli prison system to function. There are prisons and interrogation centers where Palestinian children are caged and tortured, are powered by Hewlett Packard. Last year, between October 2015 and August 2016, Israel abducted and caged 2,320 Palestinian children, some as young as 11 years old. That's more than one child taken from their parents every 4 hours. Just imagine for a second what that means. Every 4 hours, one child is taken from their parents. How many children will be taken whilst we are here at Bett? What happens to these children? Figures for Jerusalem show that 40% of the children were sexually abused by Israeli soldiers during arrest or interrogation. During interrogation, 75% of Palestinian children detained by Israel are physically tortured. The United Nations Rights of the Child report documents the brutal torture of Palestinian children as standard practice during interrogation in order to coerce confessions, usually to stone throwing, which carries a sentence of up to 20 years imprisonment. In the words of the United Nations Rights of the Child report, 4th of July 2013, children are systematically subject to degrading treatment and often to acts of torture, physical and verbal violence, humiliation, painful restraint, putting of the head and face in a sack, threatened with death, physical violence, and sexual assault against themselves or members of their family. Restricted access to toilet, to food, to water. These crimes are perpetrated from the time of arrest, during transfer and interrogation to obtain a confession, but also on an arbitrary basis, as testified by several Israeli soldiers as well as during pre-trial detention. The Public Committee Against Torture in Israel states that over 1,000 complaints of torture have been submitted, but not a single complaint has led to a criminal investigation, let alone a trial or a conviction. Israeli law has never criminalized torture, and whilst Israel is a signatory to the UN Conventions Against Torture, it insists that it doesn't apply to Palestinians. United Nations Funded Treatment and Rehabilitation Center for Victims of Torture for Occupied Palestinian Territory in 2014 treated 845 Palestinian victims of torture, including 317 women and 135 children. Hewlett Packard keeps those torture dens and dungeons where Palestinian children are caged and abused, operational by the IT infrastructure it provides to the Israeli prison service. These dungeons and torture dens are where Palestinian children as young as 12 years old are brutally tortured and caged in 1 meter by 3 meter dark holes in the ground for months without charge or trial. We want to ask Hewlett Packard, do you feel any shame in coming to a children's education event, whilst at the same time you are facilitating the torture of children in Palestine? Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 72 Palestinian prisoners have been tortured to death in Israeli prisons since 1967. The latest being father of five young children, Raid Abul Salam Al-Jabari, who died following interrogation at Eshel prison on the 9th of September 2014. He had been arrested over a simple car accident involving an Israeli settler, an illegal Israeli settler. The Israeli prison service claimed he had committed suicide by hanging himself in his cell, but the autopsy revealed he had been savagely tortured with repeated blows to the head and face, causing brain hemorrhage. His neck showed no signs of hanging. HP keeps these hellholes operational with its IT infrastructure, services and servers. Shame on you, HP!
Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
In 2012, Hewlett Packard provided the central servers for the operational system of the Israeli prison service, Sohar, and its ongoing maintenance. In a contract worth $35 million, Hewlett Packard has also executed a project for email storage and archive for the Israeli prison service. Hewlett Packard developed the Kidma information system for the Israeli prison service, which includes the prisoner's management system and intelligent subsystems, helping the occupation keeping illegal records on Palestinians it has abducted and their families. The United Nations Committee on the Rights of Children has reported that Palestinian child prisoners are often coerced to confess by sexually threatening their family members or themselves. One such case is that of Ali Shamlawi. At age 16, he was abducted from his home by Israeli soldiers. He was caged in solitary confinement for 2 weeks in a filthy 1 meter by 3 meter windowless underground cell, 3 floors below the surface, and then violently tortured. Then the interrogator, having looked up Ali's family details, realized he had a younger sister. So he sexually threatened Ali's younger sister to coerce a confession out of Ali of throwing stones. Once they had the forced confession, they sentenced Ali to 15 years imprisonment. Ali has been in prison for over 3.5 years now. Is fully complicit in these crimes. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Many of us attending this education show will be parents and teachers. We all have a responsibility and choices to make. The clearest message we can send Hewlett Packard that we don't approve of their complicity in the murder and torture of children in Palestine is by boycotting their products and letting them know why. As you go in, please visit the Hewlett Packard stand and tell them you do not support the killing and torture of children, including Palestinian children, and will be boycotting their products until they stop their complicity with Israel's war crimes. Thank you. Boycott Israel! Boycott Hewlett Packard! Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Today, there are over 6,000 Palestinian political prisoners, including women and children, many caged without charge or trial. One of them is Mohammed Al-Halabi. Mohammed is a renowned humanitarian aid worker in Gaza, heading the Christian charity World Vision Gaza Operation. UNICEF reports that Israel's attack on Gaza in 2014 left hundreds of thousands of children in trauma. Mohammed works with these traumatized children, creating safe spaces for them to try and rehabilitate them back from trauma. He also helps provide basic humanitarian assistance. Under his leadership, World Vision provides 40,000 children in Gaza. In 2014, Mohammed Al-Halabi was honored by the United Nations as its humanitarian hero. In an interview for his award, Mohammed was asked what was his most memorable experience during his work. He replied, "One of the children in our programs in 2009 had lost two of her young cousins and her hair was burned after a white phosphorus bomb had fallen on her home. She was severely traumatized, was isolated in her room and was not talking to anyone. A few months after she joined our programs, she became a leader for a group of children and I met her while she was educating them about child rights and singing for peace. I was so touched with the experience, and I will never forget the happiness I felt at that moment. Whilst on his way home to Gaza from a World Vision meeting in Jerusalem, Mohammed Al-Halabi was taken by soldiers at the crossing to Gaza. He disappeared for 21 days, prevented from seeing a lawyer. He was severely tortured. Bound to a small chair, the Israeli interrogators beat him senseless. But he still refused to sign their ludicrous confession of having diverted $50 million from World Vision Humanitarian Fund to Hamas. World Vision International CEO Kevin Jenkins pointed to discrepancies in the Shin Bet charges. World Vision's cumulative operating budget in Gaza for the past 10 years was approximately $22.5 million, which makes the alleged amount of up to $50 million being diverted hard to reconcile. He also pointed out that Mohammed Al-Halabi was the manager of our Gaza operations only since October 2014. Before that time, he managed only portions of the Gaza budget. World Vision's accountability processes cap the amount individuals in management positions at his level to assigning authority of $15,000. In response to these facts, the Israel Foreign Affairs spokesman, Emmanuel Nachson, simply replied, "It was irrelevant. The reality is that for Israel, the facts don't matter. This is not about Mohammed Al-Halabi. It's about a carefully planned attack on humanitarian providers in Gaza. A Save the Children staff worker and also a United Nations Development Programme worker have also been similarly accused of similar baseless charges. With Mohammed Al-Halabi's arrest, Israel has frozen World Vision's bank accounts in Jerusalem. This has forced World Vision to close down operations in Gaza, immediately putting at risk the lives of 40,000 children that it provides for in Gaza. Israel is not content with bombing children in Gaza. It is now after those children that survived the slaughter and those humanitarians who care for them. We have a message from the family of Mohammed Al-Halabi in Gaza.
I am Mohammed Al-Halabi's brother, Loa. My brother has been incarcerated for 7 months and tortured for 53 consecutive days. His crime? His crime consisted of having a profound humanitarian desire to help all who need help, from the children to the patients, to the fishermen and the farmers. For all that, Mohammed has paid a very steep price. In 2014, the UN named my brother as Humanitarian of the Year, and I urge all peace activists around the world to consider him as such in subsequent years. In the same name of justice, I urge all activists around the world to stand beside us in demanding freedom for my brother. Free Mohammed Al-Halabi, free all Palestinian political prisoners, and free Palestine.
We are here to demand the immediate and unconditional release of the United Nations humanitarian hero, Mohammed Al-Halabi. Free Mohammed Al-Halabi!
Free Mohammed Al-Halabi!
Free Mohammed Al-Halabi!
Free Palestine!
Let's go.